I have no issues with governments consulting the lawyers, the accountants, and the different people in the industry. Because at the end of the day, there's a difference between law and basically its application. And ultimately, the people who have to apply the law needs to understand the spirit or the intent of what is expected of them. But ultimately, we in this chamber and the government primarily is responsible for the enforcement of those laws. And one of the things that we have done in this country is that we have created a culture of the very people that we are supposed to be regulating are the ones that are writing the rules to regulate them. We cannot have the foxes writing the rules to guard the hen house. And that is one of the things that I would say to this government and the future government to take that into consideration. We do not go out and ask people who commit crime, well, how best do you think we should write this or best we should do that? We write things, we pass legislation, we write regulations, we do policies to do what is in the best interest of the country. And it is sad that we are at this point, because the truth of the fact is, Madam Chair, the very people that we depended on to help us through this issue, basically for their own self-serving purposes, basically wrote a definition that gave them a backdoor and a loophole out of this system. And it is one thing for us to have challenges within the private funds business or the mutual funds business, but we are still at the end of the day a global financial services country. And we cannot risk the entire industry for one section of the industry. The blacklisting of this country as a result of some people trying to be cute and running the risk that it did for the entire country was really unconscionable. And the reason why I want to say this, Madam Chair, is I too spoke to some of the people within the industry. And one of the most disgraceful things for me is that some of the very lawyers were quick to point out to me that, you know what, whether I register in Cayman or not, I'm still going to make my money. And